What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, John Cannon. And it's been about a week, so I guess it's time for another video. You feel me? I'm about to take y'all through some prep. I'm gonna give y'all some workout snippets here and there, because I know it wouldn't be a fitness channel without some of that, you know? But as y'all know, in about 4.5 months, I'm gonna do a competition, so I'm starting my cut now. I'm usually only like to cut for 3 months, so this first month is still gonna be in the cut, but it's just gonna be getting myself more used to what's gonna be going into me. You feel me? So I'm about to show y'all the most delicious tasting chicken breast, the easiest like autopilot meals, and I'm gonna show, and like this is really my schedule. Like, I'm about to show y'all how to do this, then go do cardio and come back and check the food. So first things first though, I just want to show y'all what y'all have to do before what I'm fit to show you. First of all, we're gonna be having black beans. What I did is, I don't know if y'all have ever done this, but you have to soak black beans, because if you just try to cook black beans, just hard black beans, straight out the freaking can or whatever, straight out the bag, it's not gonna go well for you. So soak them overnight. All right, next you're gonna get you a bag of potatoes. Right now, at the very beginning of my like meal prep, like this whole prep situation, I wanna get all my carbs cooked, because you can just refrigerate carbs for days. Like, I know a lot of people that makes y'all cringe, but like for me especially, I don't like to cook meat every single, like, I don't like to cook meat 5 days in advance, because by the fifth day you're eating rubber, you're eating wheels, my nigga. So I like to, you know, if I'm making some potatoes, them can stay in the refrigerator for 5 days. I put some hot sauce, some ketchup, some whatever on that. That's Gucci. You know what I'm saying? I'll cook some beans, them be in the refrigerator for 5 days. Rice as well. So that's what I'm trying to get ready for y'all right now. But let me show y'all the little bit of prep work that you got to do before you can just set this on autopilot. So next, you gotta soak the potatoes. Soak some starches out of that. All right, y'all, next we're gonna rinse the beans. We're gonna drain the beans. We're gonna put a little bit of water in the pan. I don't even know how much, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? I got a pound and a half of black beans. Cut that off right there, boy. Like Chris Jones say, we cooking from the soul. I got about that much water. It's gonna put that on the eye, right? Here's the key about cooking stuff that take a long time to cook. Put it on high first, all right? Then we're gonna take our beans. Might need a little bit more water than that. Gonna put our beans in here, okay? As soon as it starts to boil, hit it on low, okay? Put it on low as soon as it starts to boil. But before we do that, I'm about to show y'all something. This right here, this tip right here, change your whole life. I don't know about y'all, but beans are bland. Check this out. Where is that? Where that's at? Okay, I got some Himalayan black salt right here that it's just salt, right? Get you some salt. Get you some garlic powder and some garlic salt. I don't know what garlic does to beans, but it just puts some, oh my God, it just tastes so good. So don't be shy. Don't be shy. I'ma just looking at y'all, you feel me? I'ma garlic that water down, you feel me? Take that garlic salt. Take that garlic salt, hit that up real quick. Boom. I don't know why, but the only season that I've ever seen beans to take so well is salt and garlic. Of course, I'm gonna put some seasoning salt in it. But that's a lot of beans. So it requires a whole lot of seasoning. okay? I'm gonna put that in there, and I'm gonna put some, just some seasoning salt in there. You know what I'm saying? This is Creole seasoning. Boom. Take that like that. Y'all see that? Y'all see that? I'm gonna just mix that up. Mmm. Yeah. Oh, get it to him. Okay, we're just gonna mix that up and we're gonna wait for that to start boiling. Now my third and final carb source is gonna be some of that basmati. Y'all see that? That's a basmati, okay? All these goddamn seasonings. All right, y'all, so if you want your rice a little stickier, you're gonna do like a little stickier, like a little wetter, you're gonna do 1 cup of rice, 2 cups of water. So for every cup of rice, dry rice, you do 2 cups of wet water. You feel me? So I'm gonna, but I want mine a little drier to feel like that Chipotle feel. So I'm gonna do, for every 1 cup of rice, 1.5 cups. Oh my God. I'm gonna do, for every 1 cup of rice, I'm gonna do 1.5 cups of water. I'm about to do 3 cups of rice, so that's gonna be about like 1.5, 1.5. That's 3 plus another 1.5. 4.5 cups of water. Uno. Dos. Dora the Explorer ain't got nothing on your boy. Chris. You feel me? That boy had Spanish class in high school. That right there, that 4 cups. I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna get my last half. You feel me? Right there. 4.5. I'm not done with this rice though. I'm not done with this rice, okay? As y'all can see, everything so far has been pretty low fat, but that's because I'm gonna add oil to everything that I cook. Not much, but everything. So, for example, I don't know how much rice I'm making, how long this rice is gonna make. I'm just making big portions so that I can just prep my food quick in the morning, put it in the little container and dip. So what I'm gonna do is, I want portion control. I wanna know what I'm putting into my body. I wanna know that it's healthy or not that high, not too high in calories. Fat has a lot of calories. For every 1 gram of fat, there's 9 calories. For every 1 gram of carb, there's 4 calories. For every 1 gram of protein, there's 4 calories. So you wanna keep the fats a little lower, a lot lower. God dang, that boy looking kinda goddamn juicy, goddamn. And I'm fat right now. Anyway, I'ma just, put that much oil in all the rice. That rice may last me, that may have been what, 2 tablespoons of oil? That's 14 grams of fat, right? Or 28 grams of fat. That may last me four days. So if I eat this for 4 days in between meals, that's 28 grams of fat in 4 days, right? I'm gonna do the same thing in the beans, because the beans don't, black beans don't have too much fat at all. I'm gonna spray these potato. I'm gonna show y'all when I get to that. I'm talking too much. All right, y'all, so what I'm about to do is gonna piss off the black community as a whole, you feel me? But I just need you to understand something real quick. Just real quick, I'm gonna just explain to you while I'm doing, why I'm not doing it. Cause I had this problem too. I used to do this all the time, cause this is how I was raised. Listen, we not gonna wash this chicken, and let me tell you why. For some reason, niggas, cause like, it's just my niggas. White people that we do this, they be like, why would you do that? Listen, we're not gonna wash the chicken because washing the chicken with your lukewarm water that comes out of your faucet, unless your water comes out of your faucet boiling, okay? You're trying to wash some disease down the sink. That's not gonna do anything but spread it. That's not gonna kill it. Heat kills germs, okay? I know it sucks. Sometimes I still end up out here washing my chicken, which is stupid. It makes no sense, but it's just like ingrained in me. We're not gonna wash this chicken though. We're not gonna wash this chicken. We're gonna season it up and put it into some heat, okay? So what I'm gonna do, take this chicken. Ugh, I wanna wash it so bad because it's slimy, bruh. This is chicken breast from Wally World, you feel me? Me personally, I recommend y'all wearing some gloves, you know? Keeping gloves around, you feel me? I know a lot of people thinking, John, you about to get a disease, boy. You ain't gonna wash that chicken. Listen, 9 times out of 10, if you get sick from eating some chicken, it's not because it wasn't washed, it was because it wasn't cooked properly. You know what I'm saying? Eat garlic salt on the chicken. Boom. Bam. Just like that. This is 4 big behind chicken breasts. It's probably gonna last me about, I'll say 2.5 days. Okay. Boom. I'm generous with my seasonings, okay? I'm gonna take some actual garlic. Oh, seasonings. What seasonings in the air, boy? Give me that. Oh, give me that. Oh, give me some more of that. Take some of this chili paste, okay? Oh, yeah. Alright, last but not least, get some of this grapeseed oil. Hit that. And I'm gonna move this chicken around. Yeah. You like that, don't you, girl? Rub it into that chicken. Usually I would do this, put it in a bag, shake the bag up, leave the bag in the refrigerator overnight. But everybody ain't got that kind of time. Everybody ain't got that kind of prep time. I should have did it when I was soaking the beans, but it is what it is, fam. All right, now that you got that all moved around, this is what we gonna do. We gonna go to the oven. We gonna put the oven on 400 degrees. Oh, well, we ain't got no aluminum foil in the house, so we gonna have to thug this. I'ma put the oven on probably about 375, cause I don't, maybe 350, 375, 350. I'm gonna put the oven on 350 and just let it cook for a long time. And the reason I call this like the autopilot, like meal prep right here, is because everything now, look, I'm about to show y'all, hold up. About to pop this in the oven. Check me out. Boom. Boom. Pop that in the oven on 350. Both of these started to boil, right? I put both of them on low. That's on simmer. That's on simmer, okay? Let me show you what I'm about to do. I'm gonna take that while that's simmering right there, while this simmering right here. Bam, covered, okay? See this rice? This rice ain't doing nothing but soaking up water now, you feel me? Bam, covered. You ain't gotta come back and check this for about a good 20 minutes. And when you check that, just come in here, check that too. Usually now, I would wrap that chicken up in some foil for 20 minutes on 350, cook it real nice and slow, cause chicken breast can be juicy. Cook it real nice and slow, then take the foil from over it, let it cook down. Oh, that chicken breast just be falling off of itself. You know, but I'm gonna come back, all this is done. Except for the potatoes. I'm gonna come back and I'm just show y'all what I'm working with. Real simple, real. I'm gonna go play the game. Cause I'm not even doing cardio in the morning. I'm doing cardio at night now. All right, y'all, real quick, cause my game is loading up right now. I'm about to take the breasts. Taking these breasts right here up off the pan. They are nice and done. I'm gonna show y'all the final product in a second. But I cut the oven off at a certain point. I'm gonna drain this and put the potatoes on 400. All right, y'all, and there we have it. You see what I was talking about with the rice, how you can kind of see in between the grain, pick each grain up, and it's not all clumped together, you feel me? That rice is really good, that recipe on that rice. There goes, that's how much we made of the beans, a bunch of rice, and I made one thing of chicken because I don't like chicken to sit around for more than 2 days, to be honest. Next is gonna be chicken thigh. I don't really like chicken breast. Just had to get that out of the way because I bought it. So, that being said, y'all like that? I'm gonna put some workout clips at the end of this. Man, how y'all let me forget the potatoes like that? There go the potatoes. Hey, I'm back. I was just playing about leaving. This is the final product. I put a little bit of this Mandarin teriyaki sauce on the taters and on the chicken. I got some beans. I ain't really messing with the rice today, but this is my meals for the day. This is what I'm gonna eat while I'm at work till I get home at around 7:30. Then I'm gonna probably eat a little bit more of something like this. Go work out for my, man, whatever. Thank you.
3 months. I'm just kidding.
Like, shut it down.
You done?
So yeah, I've been doing a whole lot of squats. Bye.